New in SOLIDWORKS 2018 is the home screen. You can see we have a couple tabs here at the top where you can look through recently opened documents, the Learning Center from mysolidworks.com, and any technical alerts that we might need to know about when it comes to using SOLIDWORKS. I'm going to go ahead and open up this assembly here. And I want to give this to somebody that does not need all the internal workings of the component, but they do need to mount this into a design. So I'm going to use the Defeature tool to get rid of some of this detail. Let's take a look here. So we've got some gears, we've got some spur gears, we've got some bearings inside of here, we've got some complex geometries there. I don't need to give that to my customer or my internal facing clientele. So I'm going to use the SOLIDWORKS Defeature tool under Tools Defeature to remove some of that internal detail and external detail. So that's it to remove the internal features, and I'll ask it to remove any components that are, say, smaller than 10% of the overall size. So now that we've picked out the geometries that are going to be removed, we can come in and create any assembly motion if we want to. Without doing assembly motion, if we just don't select any components, we're just going to get a solid part as a solid block, which might be beneficial. But sometimes we want it to honor the mates in the assembly. So here I could grab a hold of the outside components, create a group, grab the output shaft, create a group, then grab the other input shaft and create a group. And it will honor the mates between those three groups, but will treat each one of those groups as its own solid part. In this situation, I just want a solid part out of the whole thing. So I'm just going to leave it as is. I can come in and pick particular faces that I want to keep as part of the design, so that way it knows that those faces are crucial and not to get rid of them inadvertently. We'll go ahead and allow it to do some of the removal. At that point, it shows us the component on the right-hand side that I would be giving to my client, and on the left-hand side, the assembly that we were working with. I can then publish that up to 3D Content Central if I want someone to be able to download it, or I can save this file just to give to somebody else, and I can link it back to the original, so if any updates happen, all I have to do is run through the Defeature tool again, and the new file gets updated. One of the things they did in 2018 was the ability to save this file with the automatic naming convention underscore Defeature at the end of the file. So that's kind of nice as a little enhancement they put in there in 2018 to make Defeature a little bit better. I'll go ahead and overwrite that. Now, if we look at this file by itself now, you can see we have a solid model. You can see we have a Defeature here with an external reference. So if we ever need to open up the other file, this one will update automatically. If we cut a section view through here, you can see the internal geometries for the gears aren't there anymore. It filled it all in, which is kind of nice. Now you can give this to somebody. They can mount it into an assembly, have proper sizing and everything, and be able to order your part without giving away all the IP. So they've added some nice things there in 2018 with the Defeature tool. I hope you like it.